गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय नेम इज मोहम्मद दानिश फ्रॉम झारखंड पब्लिक स्कूल। वी ऑल आर सिटिंग हियर टुडे टू अटेंड द इन-हाउस ट्रेनिंग सेशन एंड द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चाइल्ड्स राइट। एंड टुडे आवर रिसोर्स पर्सन इज मिस्टर राजीव रंजन सर। आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट हिम टू प्लीज कम हियर एंड अटेंड द प्रोग्राम सेशन। सर प्लीज।
Thank you, sir, and all of you are welcome here in the session of in-house training session. This is the first training session of this year 2023-24, and our topic, we are at health topic on the child right protections. I, Rajiv Raman Sinha, what are the protection of children's rights? Children's rights are human rights that are accumulated expectly to the children's needs, want and overall well-being. They take into the account their fragility, specifications and age appropriate requirements. Children's right aim to take into account the necessity of the development of a child. Right to protection. A child has a right to be protected from neglect, exploitation and abuse at home and elsewhere, school. Right to participation. A child has a right to participate in any decision making that involves him or her directly or indirectly. India, in its bid to become an ethical labor market in international cooperation in 1991, ratified the United Nations Convention on the Right of Children in 1992. The conversation stemmed from job desire to end the suffering of children, giving them instead a healthy, happy and safe environment that nurtured them physically, mentally and emotionally. These facts find a strong response resonance of conversation. Child right to beyond just human right, which exists to ensure fair and proper treatment of people across the world and promote their well-being. Children defines as any person under the age of 18 need more than just human right due to a set of unique needs streaming from their valuable. Further, the children right in the Indian Constitution as described in the convention has been summarized into a following fundamental with references to the various articles. The right to the to an identity, article 7 and 8. Children are entitled to a name legally registered with the government and nationally to belong to the country. Further, they must have the right to an identity in the form of public record. This ensures national support as well as access to social services. Second, the right to health, article 23 and 24. Medical care, nutrition, protection from harmful habits including drugs and safe working environments are covered under the right to health and article 23 and 24 on child right in the Indian Constitution and elaborate on the access to special care and support from children with special needs as well as quality health care including drinking water, nutrition and a safe environment respectively. Third, the right to education from the Constitution, Article 28, right to free primary education is critical for helping children develop discipline, life skills, while finding a safe and healthy environment to nurture a child's psychological development. This include freedom from violence, abuse, or neglect. Number 4, the right to a family life, Article 8, 9, 10, 16, 20, 22, and 40. If not family member, then children have the right to be looked after by caretakers. Children must live with their parents until it is harmful to them. However, family reunification, permission for family members living in different countries to travel to renew contact between family members is critical. Under the work of caretaker or family, they must be provided privacy against attacks on their way of life and professional history. Children who do not have access to a family life has a right to special care and must be looked after properly by people who respect either ethnic group, religion, culture, and language. Refugee children have a right to special protection and help. In the case of misbehavior, children have the right to seek legal counsel under the Geneva Justice Mechanism with the fair and speedy resolution of proceedings. Number 5, the right to be protected from violence. Article 19 and 34, protection from violence extend even to family members, and children must not suffer ill treatments or sexual or physical violence. This includes as of use of violence as a means of discipline. All forms of sexual exploitations and abuse are unacceptable, and this article takes into view the sale of children, child protection, and child pornography. Number 6, the right to an opinion, Article 12 and 13. According to the England Constitution, Article 12 and 13, all children deserve the right to voice their opinions free of criticism or contempt in a situation where adults are actively deciding upon choice on behalf of children. The latter are initiated to have their opinions taken into consideration while children's opening. While children's opinion may not be based on facts, it is nonetheless an important source of insight for parents and should be considered. However, this depends on the child's level of maturity and age. Children have the freedom of expression as long as they are not harming others with their opinions and knowledge. Number 7, the right to be protected from armed conflict. Article 38 and 39, our Constitution of India gives their children armed conflict converts innocent children into refugees. Prisoners or participate in armed conflicts, and these are all circumstances which contravene with the spirit of war or any armed struggle can severely damage our child's morale as well as perceptions of ethics, and the must be corrected in a nurturing, safe environment while seeking to rehabilitate children affected by war. The government must also ensure that children are not forced to be participate in any armed struggle. Number 8, the right to be protected from exploitation under Article 19, 32, 34, 36 and 39. An exploitation is usually achieved through violent means. Protection from violence is critical for freeing children from exploitation. This extends to abuse, neglect and violence by parents. Even it is justified as an instrument of achieving discipline at home, further the children cannot be made to work in difficult or dangerous conditions. Children can only volunteer to work doing safe course from do not compromise their health or access to education or play. Sexual exploitation. Another dimension of exploitation is also prohibited as an activity that take advantage of them. Survivors of neglect, abuse and exploitation must have special help to enable recovery and reintegration into society. Children also cannot be punished purely even if it is under the ambit of the justice system. Death or life sentence as well as sentences with adult prisoners are not permitted. So we can say that all children deserve equality despite their difference. They are initiated to all of these rights, no matter what race, color, reason, language, ethnicity, gender or ability define them. Protecting India's children from violence, abuse and exploitation. Over the past 5 years, notable efforts have been made to set up fast track code and deal with cyber crime against children and women. In 2019, the Protection of Child and Sexual Offences Bill was amended strict punishment for sexual crimes against children. Violence against children is whispered and remained a harsh reality for millions of children from all socio-economic groups in India. Both girls and boys in India face early marriage, domestic abuse, sexual violence and at home, in school, trafficking, online violence, child labor and bullying, all forms of violence, abuse and exploitation have lifelong consequences of children's life. The exact data of violence, abuse and exploitation is not sufficient, but overall the nation is becoming increasingly aware of violence against children, especially sexual abuse, serial cases that may have earlier gone unnoticed and now being reported. How does Indian Constitution protect the rights? So I have told earlier different types of articles by which children can be protected from this type of violences and abuses.
Constitution of India guarantees all children certain rights which have been specially included for them. This include right to free and compulsory elementary education for all children in the 6 to 14 age group. Article 21A. How does the Indian Constitution protect the rights of children? The provisions are: children have the right to an adequate standard of living, health, care, education, and services, and to play and recreation. These include balanced diet, a warm bed to sleep, and access to schooling. Protection child. Children have the right to protection from abuse, neglect, exploitation, and discrimination. How can we protect our child rights? The government should make sure that children are not abused or sued. Children should be protected from any activities that could harm their development. Children who break the law should not be treated cruelly. They should not be put in prison with adults and should be able to keep in contact with their families. What are the four basic child rights? According to Government of India, a child life begins after 20 weeks of conception, hence the right to survival is inclusive of the child right to the whole right to minimum standard of food, shelter and clothing, and the right to live with dignity. Children's right, the human right that are acquired specially. Children protection is a part of safeguard process. In focus of protection, individual children identified as suffering or likely to suffer significant harm. This include child protection procedures which detail how to respond to concern about a child. Child right means बाल संरक्षण. बाल संरक्षण की परिभाषा क्या है? बाल संरक्षण सुरक्षा प्रक्रिया का हिस्सा है या अलग अलग बच्चों को सुरक्षा पर ध्यान केंद्रित करता है, उन्हें पीड़ित या महत्वपूर्ण नुकसान होने की संभावना के रूप में पहचाना जाता है. इसमें बाल संरक्षण प्रक्रियाएं शामिल हैं जो विस्तार से बताती हैं कि किसी बच्चे के बारे में चिंताओं का जवाब कैसे दिया जाता है. The core of child protection legislation of children is enshrined in four laws. The Juvenile Justice Care and Protection Act 2000, amended in 2015. The Prohibition of Children Marriage Act 2006. The Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act 2012. And the Child Labour Protection and Regulation Act 1986. The healthy development of children is crucial to the future well-being of any society because they are still developing. Children are especially valuable, more so than adults, to poor living conditions such as poverty, inadequate health care, nutrition, safe water, housing, and environment protections. The four pillars of child right. The Convention of the Right of the Child comprises the four pillars: the right to survival, the right to protection, the right to development, and the right to participation. What are the four types of child rights? There are four broad classification of these rights. These four categories cover all civil, political,
social, economic and cultural right of every child. Child rights started in India in 1960. The government of India enacted the Children's Act 1960, which was acceptable in Union Territories. In 1974, India formulated its first National Policy of Children, NPC. And 1979 is declared as International Year of Child by the United Nations. This includes providing food, shelter, clothing, education, medical care and emotional support. It also includes protecting the child from harm and ensuring their safety. Particularly, human rights of children include, among other rights, the right to life, the right to a name, the right to express his views in matters concerning the child, the right of freedom of thoughts, conscience and religion, the right to health care, the right to protection from economic and sexual exploitations. The 5 P's of child protection. 5 P's means, first P is called prevention, second paramountcy, third partnership, fourth protection and fifth parental responsibility. Make your children aware of these P's for an awake situation and they don't understand. What is the Child Protection Act 1986? It came on the status book as the Child Labor Prohibition and Regulation Act 1986 of an act to it is an act to prohibit the argument of children, engagement of children in certain employment and to regulate the conditions of work of children in certain other employments. POSCO. जैसा कि आप जानते हैं कि चाइल्ड राइट के अंदर अगर आप किसी बच्चे को अब फिजिकली मेंटली अब्यूज़ करते हैं तो वैसी स्थिति में आप पॉस्को एक्ट के शिकार होते हैं और पॉस्को एक्ट के तहत आपके ऊपर कार्रवाई की जा सकती है. तो व्हाट इज़ द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ पॉस्को? द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ पॉस्को इज द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चाइल्ड फ्रॉम ऑफ सेक्सुअल ऑफेंस, CEO एक्ट. In present time, you have noticed that you are listening some wrestlers. Some wrestlers are sitting कुछ wrestlers जो हैं वो धरने पर बैठे हुए हैं, लगातार वे धरने दे रहे हैं. तो धरने देने का रीज़न जो है, तो धरने देने का रीज़न क्या है? तो जो रेसलर्स हैं वो अपने अध्यक्ष, उनका जो रेसलिंग फेडरेशन का जो अध्यक्ष है उनका नाम है ब्रिजभूषण शरण सिंह, उनके ऊपर कुछ एलिगेशंस लगाए गए हैं कि वो नाबालिग बच्चों के साथ या फिर जो रेसलर्स हैं जो कि अपने देश के लिए मेडल्स ला रहे हैं उनके ऊपर एलिगेशंस हैं कि वे चाइल्ड अब्यूजिंग करते हैं या फिर उस तरह की कुछ क्रियाएं करते हैं. तो उनके खिलाफ जो कुछ रेसलर्स हैं वे लोग इस एक्ट के अंदर पॉस्को एक्ट लगाने का काम कर रहे हैं. कि उनके ऊपर पॉस्को एक्ट के तहत कार्रवाई की जाए, क्योंकि इसमें एक नाबालिग रेसलर का भी नाम इसमें आया था और उसके तहत पॉस्को एक्ट लगाने की उनके ऊपर कार्रवाई का बार बार बातें आ रही हैं। बाद में वो नाबालिग बच्ची और उसके गार्जियन का जो भी आता है बात की, वो उनके साथ वैसा कुछ नहीं हुआ है, उनके बच्चे का सिलेक्शन नहीं हुआ था, इस वजह से उन्होंने झूठा आरोप लगाया। ये सारी अलग चीज़ें हैं, लेकिन पॉस्को एक्ट जो है वो बच्चों के सुरक्षा के दृष्टिकोण से भारत सरकार ने इसे शुरू किया है, ताकि बच्चों के साथ जो इस प्रकार की घृणित क्रियाएं होती हैं वो ना हो पाए, वो उनसे बचे। What are the 10 most important children's rights? So, the first right to enjoy the highest attainable standard of health. Second right to non-discrimination. Third, right to be protected from economic exploitation. Fourth, right to be protected from unnecessary treatment and investigation. Fifth, right to avoid pain, fear and stress. Sixth, right to have their parents with them, and 7th, right to privacy, 8th, right to be informed, 10 rights to the children's. Children's rights are human rights. In 1989, the United Nations declared the Convention of the Right of Children, promoting the rights and the protection of children to develop their full potential, free from hunger and want, neglect and abuse. Article 24 of the United Nations Convention of the Right of Children addresses the right and the special demand of children in healthcare institutions, recognize that children are especially vulnerable. The age charter 1988 recognizes and endorses the right of the child as stapled in the Union Convention of the Rights of the Children, and in particular the key principle that in all situations the best interests of the child above prevails. As commitment to the Convention of the Rights of Children and each character of supporting initiative adjust this to the respective simulation and issue that follow of right. Right to enjoy the highest attainable standard of health. Children have the right to enjoy the highest attainable standard of health. Specialist pandemic are should be provided for all children, particularly children aged less than 3 years should be treated by experienced staff that follow continuous education, regular trainings and updates to maintain that their companies. Children who have significant comorbidity and those who require highly specialized or major surgery benefits from specialized ethnic care in health pandemic centers. Rights to non-discrimination. All children should be treated in a respectful and empathic way, whatever their race, religion, abilities, whatever they think or say, whatever type of family they come from. It doesn't matter where children live, what language they speak, what their parents do, whatever they are, boy or girl, what their culture is, whatever they have a disability or whether they are rich or poor. No child should be treated unfairly or any basis. Right to be protected from economic exploitation. Children need to be protected from any economic exploitation in health care. Profit motivated treatment of children in hospitals and medical institutions of law quality should be avoided. Right to be protected from unnecessary treatment and investigation. Children need to be protected from unnecessary treatment and investigation that include any potential harm and burden associated with their involvement in research, teaching or training of medical staff. Right to be avoid pain, fear and stress. All children should be treated without suffering from pain, fear and unnecessarily stress. They should benefit from all forms of anesthesia and procedural sedation whenever they or their caregiver asks for. Children should have full access to pain therapy and palliative care. Some pain, fear and stress may be inevitable, but all efforts should be undertaken to minimize this. Right to have their parents with them. Children have the right to have their parents with them during the induction of anesthesia and during recovery. Although this may not always be possible or appropriate, the view of the child and the caregiver should always be taken into account. Right to privacy. The privacy of children should be respected at all times during induction and maintenance of anesthesia and recovery. This includes also protection against exposure during physical examination and personal hygiene activities, brushing, toileting and bathing, protection against treatment and behavior which diminishes self-respect or makes the child feel ridiculous or humiliated. Right to be informed. Children and adolescents have the right to information on all aspects of health which enable them to make informed choices. They have the right to get and share information about treatment and procedures. During anesthesia, sedation and pain therapy in a manner appropriate to age and understanding as long as the information is not damaging on them or other participation is decision making require advance information about all measures that need to be taken. Right to be heard. Children have the right to be heard and to express their wishes, concerns and fears. According to age, understanding and level of development, they have the right to be involved in the contribute to the medical decision making process in anesthesia, sedation and pain therapy. to be cared for together with children who have the same development needs. Children have the right to receive treatment during anesthesia, sedation and pain therapy in the child. Friendly environment where they can enjoy emotional and physical simulations suited to their age and condition. Their measures help to minimize anxiety and normalize what can be an abnormal situation. Here I am giving some references. What are the child right? The right to life. The right to life means that each child must be able to live his or her own life. Children have to have the right not to be killed. They have the right to survive and to grow up in proper condition. Why this is most important for the child's right? As के परिदृश्य में आपने या आप यह देखते हैं, सुनते हैं अपने आस पड़ोस में, अपने शहर में, अपने मोहल्ले में इस तरह की चीज़ें जो होती है कि डिस्क्रिमिनेशन होता है, लड़के हैं लड़कियां हैं, लड़के लड़कियों के बीच में डिस्क्रिमिनेशन होता है। और अगर कोई नवजात शिशु अगर वो लड़की होती है तो वैसी स्थिति में उसे अपनी माँ के भोग में ही उसे मार देना या तो फिर जन्म के उपरांत उसे मार देना, तो ये सारी गलत चीज़ें हैं और ये चाइल्ड राइट के अंडर डाला गया है, जिससे कि किसी भी कोई भी बच्चा जो कि इस पृथ्वी पर आने वाला है या आ चुका है उसे इस परिदृश्य में उसके उसकी मौत ना हो जाए, उसे मार ना दिया जाए। तो सबसे पहला तो इसमें सरकार के द्वारा हमारे गवर्नमेंट के द्वारा अमेंडमेंट करने के पश्चात इसमें इस चाइल्ड एक्ट में सबसे पहले तो आप भ्रूण नवजात जो भ्रूण है वो लड़का है या लड़की है इसकी आप जांच भी नहीं करवा सकते हैं। और अगर जांच भी नहीं करवा सकते हैं और अगर आपने जांच करवा भी लिया है तो आप किसी भी तरह से जो अबॉर्शन की प्रक्रिया होती है उसे आप नहीं करवा सकते हैं। तो ये भी चाइल्ड राइट के अंदर है कि जो राइट टू लाइफ कि आप किसी बच्चे को मार नहीं सकते हैं, ये उनका अधिकार है, उनका जन्म लेना, उनका इस पृथ्वी पर आना और इस पृथ्वी पर सही तरीके से सही से उनका जीवन जीना, ये सभी उनके राइट्स के अंदर आता है। एक्ट नंबर 60 ऑफ 1960 डेटेड 26 दिसंबर 1960 एंड एक्ट टू प्रोवाइड फॉर द केयर, प्रोटेक्शन, मेंटेनेंस, वेलफेयर, ट्रेनिंग, एजुकेशन एंड रिहैबिलिटेशन ऑफ नेगलेक्ट और डेलिक्वेंट चिल्ड्रेन एंड फॉर द ट्रायल ऑफ डेलिक्वेंट चिल्ड्रेन इन द यूनियन टेरिटरीज। 9 रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज ऑफ obligation of children to parents: love and respect them; second, protecting and taking care of them; obeying your parents; asking the parents permission and blessing; helping parents work; keeping the good name and child's mandate of parents coming immediately when your parent comes। तो ये सारी चीज़ें हैं कि जिस प्रकार से चाइल्ड का एक राइट है, तो अगर उनका जो अधिकार है तो उनका कुछ कर्तव्य भी बनता है अपने पेरेंट्स के प्रति। तो ये कुछ बातें हैं जो कि बच्चों को भी माननी चाहिए। अगर आप बच्चे के अच्छे भविष्य के लिए, अच्छे सेहत के लिए, उनके अच्छे जीवन के लिए, उनके अच्छी पढ़ाई के लिए, उनके अच्छे भोजन के लिए आप अगर दिन रात मेहनत करते हैं तो बच्चे का भी एक कर्तव्य बनता है कि वो आप पेरेंट्स के लिए भी कुछ अच्छा करें, उन्हें भी सपोर्ट करें। सो द कंक्लूजन इज दैट बच्चों के बेहतर भविष्य के लिए, अच्छे काम के लिए कई तरह के जब एक्ट्स तैयार किए गए हैं ताकि बच्चों का भविष्य सुरक्षित हो, वे अच्छा कर सके, तो उसके लिए उन पर भी कुछ उनके भी कुछ अधिकार हैं। इस प्रकार से संविधान के द्वारा और कानून बना करके उन्हें कुछ अधिकार दिए गए हैं, ठीक उसी प्रकार से बच्चों के लिए बच्चों के कुछ कर्तव्य भी हैं जिन्हें कि उन्हें उनका पालन करना चाहिए। इन्हीं सभी बातों के साथ आज का ये ट्रेनिंग सेशन मैं समाप्त करता हूँ। धन्यवाद। जय हिंद। जय भारत।